Hello everyone, we are Team Sunspot Analyst Package, aka TSA Package. We'll deliver a presentation about our analysis result on sunspot number prediction data using ARMA models. Before we are going further on the presentation, let me introduce our team member, Adalbert, Ruda, and me, Agung. Okay, here we go. Solar activity had been studied through a lot of research, since the changing value on solar activity is really affecting the telecommunication instrument and signal wave, satellite positioning, predicting the Earth temperature in the future, and predicting the changing on the ultraviolet and soft X-ray emission level. In this project, we are working with monthly sunspot data from Australian Bureau of Meteorology Space Weather Services, which start from January 1998 to December 2016. As we can see on the time series plot, there are two characteristics that easily can be found on this data: the changing variance and trend-like sinus pattern. Further, because there is no pattern can be seen in each year, we can say that there is no seasonality evident across the years. By investigating further through some data tests, we will know that there are some issues in monthly sunspot data. First, it is right skewness. Second, this data is not normal. Third, high autocorrelation. To deal with changing variance in the data, we apply Box-Cox transformation with lambda equals to 0.5. Although the changing variance was already not seen, by seeing this plot, there is an evident trend which suggests the use of differencing. But we found that the sunspot series possesses natural stationary process. This conclusion was derived from the use of over 200 years of monthly sunspot data. This slide shows our project data as the part of the over 200 years of monthly sunspot data. A Dickey-Fuller unit root test was applied to this entire series. Results show that the entire monthly sunspot data is stationary. Therefore, it can be considered that the part of the data is also stationary. Considering the data has been stationary, next, we are going to proceed the ARMA model. In this step, we are selecting ARMA models candidate that were specified through ACF, BACF, EACF, and BIC graph. By investigating all of this graph, we got 10 possible models. Next, we were conducting model diagnostic and selecting the best model based on significant parameter, model residual test, and AIC-BIC score. Based on this summary, it can be seen that AR1, AR2, and MA1 parameters are consistently significant throughout the models. This result could possibly indicate their importance presence in the data. Then, by looking at AIC and BIC score, ARMA23 is the best model among 10 possible models. From the parameter estimation in ARMA23, we got almost all the parameters significant. The residual test also looked good, but if we carefully look at the residual plot, we could see the residuals exhibit a slight downward trend. To account this problem, we were trying to fit a linear trend term alongside the current model. The linear trend model that was added to current model could be specified like this, where the beta parameter correspond to the linear trend estimators, and the error terms in this model follows an ARMA23 process. From the parameter estimation in ARMA23 with linear trend, we also got almost all the parameters significant. More importantly, We also got the linear trend parameter also is significant. The model residual also performed well in all residual tests, especially for the residual plot. When we compare this residual plot with ARMA 2-3 model residual we got before, we could see the slight downward trend appear in the previous model could be accounted for. Moreover, the AIC and BIC scores of this model are smaller than previous model. So, in this case, ARMA 2-3 with linear trend model is a more desirable choice as the best model. Next, we will use the model we specified to predict the future sunspot number. On the previous slide, we found that ARMA 2-3 with linear model performed better in terms of residual plot and the AIC-BIC score. In this slide, we will see the performance of both models in predicting the future values of sunspot numbers. When we see the predicting value from both models, we can imply, first, we could see both prediction pattern almost resembles the data pattern. Second, ARMA 2-3 with linear trend seems better in predicting the values because it has smaller confidence interval than ARMA 2-3. Third, the decreasing trend on the ARMA 2-3 with linear trend looks longer than ARMA 2-3. Fourth, both of models predict the next maximum sunspot number value smaller than the previous maximum value. So, before finishing this presentation, let us remind all of us by quoting this thing. While ancient civilization worshipped the sun, we are as the future analysts and data scientists might be at least give our attention to what's happening on the sun. Thanks for the time and your attention. Bye-bye.